Hello Jazz World, I'm Lionel Loueke. I've got one of the most prominent musicians today in the world of jazz. I have Lionel Loueke here. What's up?
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. It's good to meet you again. How's the weather in London today?
It's nice. Paris was better, but you know, I'm sorry. But
was it sunny then?
Yeah, it was cool.
You were born in Benin?
Yes.
Where about in Benin?
In Cotonou.
How is the music down there? Is there any jazz in it?
No, there's no jazz. You know, but there's a lot of, you know, music scene.
Definitely the tradition of music. And, wow, beautiful. You started playing percussion before you picked up the guitar. When did you exactly got into music? What age?
Well, you know, like most of the kids in Benin, at between 9 and 11, I was playing percussion. But you know, the idea is, it wasn't really for us. It's not really playing music. It's just, you know, playing around like playground.
Yeah.
But actually, it did help me. I can say today because I learned a lot. And then I picked up the guitar when I was 17.
Whoa.
Late.
You went to the National Institute of Arts in Cote d'Ivoire, and from there you went to American School of Modern Music in Paris, and from there you went to Berklee College of Music. And the Talent Monk Institute of Jazz in Los Angeles. Why did you first go to Cote d'Ivoire?
Well, Cote d'Ivoire for me was, you know, before Cote d'Ivoire I never studied music. I didn't know anything about solfège. You know?
All right.
And I wanted to go to a school in Paris.
All right.
And I knew that the requirement was, you need a background as a musician, be able to read a little bit.
Yeah.
And the only place I could go in West Africa was Ivory Coast. And the main reason is in Africa they speak French.
Yeah.
And Benin is a French, old French colony, so I could go to South Africa. But you know, at that time I couldn't speak any word of English.
Okay. Right, Virgin Forest, your album. Yeah. Is there any story behind the title? Virgin Forest.
Well, the story about Virgin Forest is you know, what we all know about the global warming, you know, the nature, the animals. I'm not really an animal person, but I do respect it.
Okay, I get it. Yeah. One of the things I love about the album Virgin Forest is the humanity behind each song on the album, and my favorite track on the album is
Yeah.
I really love it.
Thank you.
It's got that kind of eye-level juju feel to it. How did you come about this?
You know, most of my melody, I don't think about too much.
Okay.
I just, whatever comes first, and in that case was the melody.
Okay.
And then I wrote the lyrics after all. Ponopete is, classic lyric.
All right.
Has another meaning, which is like a quarter, 25 cents.
All right, okay.
And what we usually do is, you know, you go to the party with your plastic bag, you fold it until it looks like 25 cents
in
your pocket. You know, you wear your big African dress.
And
when you get to the party, you know, if you have to cry or laugh, whatever, just wait for the food, and once the food is there, put, you know. And I say, well, I should, write something about it.
That's so beautiful.
People love it.
That's so beautiful. Are there any composers you admire? Like admire the work?
Oh yes. In jazz world, definitely Wayne Shorter.
Well, that's the man.
That's my number one, you know. I like, you know, of course I love Herbie's writing. I like a lot of, I listen a lot to classical music.
Okay.
Contemporary classical. Ravel, Debussy, Tchaikovsky,
Stravinsky,
exactly.
Okay.
So, you know, I get a lot inspired by this.
Okay. Have you done any work with Angeli Kidjo at all?
Yes, I play on her last CD, I think. It came out May 1st or something. It should be out in the UK very soon. Okay. Maybe it is out today.
The musicianship on the album Virgin Forest is so high. How did you get these guys together?
Well, you know, it's important for me to play with musicians before I had a chemistry connection. like tonight, you know, because I like guys, Frank Nelaton Jones from Hungary, and Massimo Biocati from Italy. And I have a few guests, that's my trio. And then Virgin Forest, I have a few guests, like some tracks in duo with Gretchen Parato, who's a great singer from LA. Uh-huh. She lives in the United States. She lives in New York.
Okay.
And I have Big Herbie on two tracks.
Uh-huh.
And Ciro Batista, percussion player from Brazil, on a few tracks too. And Virgin Forest, it's important for me to do this album because basically it's a resume of, you know, what I've done from Africa to today.
Yeah.
So if you listen, you see the prelude,
yeah,
so just percussions and voice using the same team for the next.
And you bring the tempo down as well.
Yeah, it's sometimes fast, sometimes slow down. Yeah. I slow down, but the team's still the same. The only difference is when I start with the band, the harmony has a harmony behind it.
Do you ever play bebop at all? Like bebop music?
Yeah, you know. I don't do it as much as I used to. You know, when I was Berkeley, of course.
I know, you have to play that.
You have to, that's how you learn. It's a language, you know. And
yeah.
I think I'm still using that in my music.
Oh, right.
But for the next album, probably be, definitely be in trio.
Okay.
I'll probably play some standard because the music I'm writing is different compared to Virgin Forest.
What do you think about Nigerian musicians?
Oh man, they're good, you know. I mean, musicians in general in Africa, they're very good. They have, you know, especially when they play what they do the best, which is like the African music, you know. The musicians in general in Africa are good.
And definitely.
One of the reasons is we learn to play by ears, you know.
Definitely.
We don't use any music.
Any
Nobody
chat.
Puts any chat on in front of you. But, I mean, it has a good side. Not too good,
yeah, no,
because once you get, you know, once you get used to that, it's good. But really, to be able to play other music, you need to understand.
Definitely.
So it'll be good if, you know, they can open up.
Yeah.
They, you know, what people know you for, and good. But you know, there's more outside. You know, like Herbie always said. He said, you know, the best part is the unknown. Like get out of your comfort zone and try it. It may work, it may not, but at least you try it, you know.
Finally, you have people like us, she studying jazz music in the university. What advice do you have for us? Because God willing, we all look one day, we're going to be like you. So what advice do you have for us?
Use the time you are in school to study, because I remember teachers were telling, oh man, you know, once you get out there, it's going to be hard for you to practice. And I can see it, because the things I miss the most right now is practicing. Because
it's in the blood.
Yeah, now it's like basically you get on stage and try and practice. You can try different things, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But again, the main phrase for me is keep trying. Because if you don't try, you don't get anything back for sure. You know, everybody has their own voice. You just have to find who are you and accept it. You know?
Definitely.
So my advice would be, you know, you just use the time they have in school and just focus them and do it.
True.
And just focus them and do it.
Thanks
for
spending your precious time for us.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. God bless you.
Pablo de Kakanaku, Wabindu Bell. Ranti Jeran Wemina Hobo, Dokapo Gopo. Zebetu Zela, Doye Mwana Mwampo. Malonu Yeni Dokbe.